I just don't get it, man. I smoke, I drink, I screw. Why wouldn't Kylie Porter dig me?
Well, maybe she has a boyfriend, dude.
Nah, she doesn't.
How do you know?
I checked into it. Want to hit?
Yeah, sure, man.
I mean, I sit behind her every day in history and stare at her black thong. God, she's hot.
Hey, dude. You know what? I'll catch up with you later. We'll play some Halo or something.
Righteous, dude. We'll do.
Alright.
Matthew, you're home early.
Yeah, press got canceled.
Oh, you want to tell me about it?
Nope.
Come on, tell me about it.
Screw you.
You know, I don't appreciate your fucking tone, mister.
This morning we discussed the significance of unleavened bread in Jesus' time.
Really? What's that?
Well, George, it's bread that doesn't rise.
Who the hell would eat that?
Well, lots of people back in Jesus' day.
Stupid. Matthew, you get those geography grades up yet?
Working on it.
You working on it, or you got it up?
I'm working on it.
Because I saw Miss Bildegard today outside the store.
Oh, hey, Mrs. Bildegard. How's Matthew doing in your class?
I haven't seen him lately. Is he sick?
He's gonna be.
She's almost blind, and I sit in the back.
Now, damn it, Matthew! You little bastard, don't you want to succeed in life?
George! Shut up!
May I be excused?
No.
Screw this.
What?
You didn't have to scream like that.
You know, fine. Let him fail. Seems like that's what you want anyways.
Don't say that.
Eat up. Don't want your food to get cold.
Have you talked to Matthew yet?
About?
You know, husband, wife, alone time.
Sex? Shh. Don't beat around the bush, just come out and say it.
You'll have to talk to him.
All right, I will.
He's a freshman in high school, George.
All right, shit, I'll talk to him, okay? Matthew. Matthew, would you shut that crap off?
Don't you know how to knock?
I did. 6 times. If you weren't listening to that satanic music, you'd hear me knock. If you heard me knock, you'd answer the door.
Well, sorry.
Cut out the disrespect. You remind me of when I was talking to my father the other day.
Georgie, you need to find a better job.
Would you just die?
What do you need?
I need to talk to you about something.
Well, can it wait? I mean, Bill's gonna come over to jam.
There will be no jamming in this house, Matthew.
Chill out, we won't bother you.
Everything you do bothers me. Remember yesterday?
Matthew, welcome home!
Will you knock that shit off?
Come on, sometimes you're just ridiculous.
Listen, Matthew. I need to talk to you about something.
Okay.
Have you ever been in love?
No.
Well, you know, when a man and a woman are in love, they tend to like each other, physically.
Okay, where's this going?
Well, do you remember the stork that used to bring the babies? Well, those babies, to make those babies, a man actually has to take his penis and...
Oh, sorry, Dad, I gotta take this, it's Bill. Oh. Hey, Bill! What's going on? Oh, really? Yeah, dude, I'll be over in a couple minutes. Okay, see ya. Sorry, Dad, I got a jet.
Well, we're not done talking, Matthew.
Nah, some other time.
Little son of a bitch.
Life is an endless journey. Pick up a few pennies on the way. You sleep with a few fatties. Then you drink from the fountain of youth. At least that's how I do it.
Bo, you've been my best friend since you dropped out of school in fifth grade, but sometimes I just don't see where you're coming from.
Respect the dead man.
Respect the dead?
Hell yeah, a lot of famous people have died. George Washington, the founder of the U.S. of P. Babe Ruth, the inventor of those wonderful chocolate bars. And Reuben Studdard.
I don't think he's dead.
Oh, really? Because I haven't seen him on E lately.
Bo, I came here to talk to you about something.
Hot dog?
No, thank you. I came here to talk to you because you seem to know what to do in any case.
Georgie, I'm here to help.
The wife, Amy.
You want to drown her away from the bathtub?
No. She wants me to talk to Matthew about sex.
Well, how old is the boy?
15.
Oh, shit. I was banging hotties when I was 9.
Yeah, I know.
Just the other day, I picked those fine little chicky. Hey, wanna go to my place and do me?
Sure!
All you need to do is hire some woman to show your son the blueprint of intercourse.
Like a hooker?
No, not like a hooker. Just somebody who sleeps with men for work.
That's a hooker.
Well, I guess that would be a hooker.
Hey, hey, baby.
You looking for a good time?
Actually, I just need you to show my son a few things.
Hey, I'll make all your fantasies come true for $10 a minute.
Well, I guess I'll owe you $5 then. Actually, I just need you to talk to my son for a little bit. Show him some stuff.
I'll make him scream like a girl.
Now, listen, ma'am. You're not listening to me. I just need to buy you for a few minutes to explain some stuff to my son, all right?
I can do anything you want, baby.
Would you stop acting like a slut for 2.5 seconds? God, you remind me of my wife.
Well, good night, George.
Slut.
So, what do you say?
Matthew, can you shut that stuff off? We have guests.
Sorry, Dad. Me and Bill were just jamming out some tunes.
Well, let's take a break from it. I'd like you to meet somebody. Matthew, this is Carlina. She's a hooker. Do you know what a hooker is?
I do.
Bill, could you please stay out of this?
Hey.
Stay out of this or go home, please. Hey.
What the hell's going on?
Now, Matthew, I brought her here to teach you some stuff. Now, she just showed me some stuff in the bathroom, and it was pretty kinky.
That's disgusting.
Disgusting, yes. Sick, yes. Maybe so. But I don't think you understand the gravity of the situation here. Your mother wants me to teach you about something, Bill, or she'll have my nuts!
What, teach me about the hooker business?
Oh, he's a feisty one, isn't he?
Would you stop it, bitch!
Come on, Bill, let's get out of here.
No, I... Not Matthew!
I smoked a marijuana cigarette of Bill's the other day, and I liked it, too. They want to keep
mine.
Doing it.
I found it.
You be home for dinner.
Well, I guess my job's done.
Wait, hold on. Wait. How about a freebie?
Yeah, that was totally weird.
Yeah, dude. My dad talked to me about sex, but I already know everything.
Yeah, I know you know. Didn't you get with the Thompson twins on the same night last New Year's Eve?
Yeah, I did, but my dad has no clue. He still thinks I'm in third grade.
Yeah, if I got with the Thompson twins on the same night, I'd die a happy man. God, they're hot. Want some?
No, it's alright. Say, how do you play with all that shit in your system anyway?
I don't know. Fuck. It's not as bad as that time I had to give the Gettysburg report when I was high as fuck. Gettysburg was... Oh, God, I'm big. Oh, I'm Bill, by the way. What are you thinking about?
Oh, just that time you were high in class.
You're fucked, man.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Ah, shit!
Okay, George?
Yeah, just got a paper cut. No, just come in here, would you, Amy?
What is it, honey?
Well, I tried to talk to Matthew about intercourse.
Oh, good. How did it go?
Well, it went about as good as the time I tried to teach him not to pee into the wind.
Now, Matthew, watch what happens when I pee in the wind. Have I made myself clear?
Anyways, I asked Bo for advice.
Well, good. Bo will know how to take care of everything.
Yeah, so I hired this prostitute, and I figured they know the most about the subject matter, right?
Right.
But, that didn't go over well, so I just don't know what to do.
Well, just speak from your heart, dear. Speak from your heart, and the right thing will come to you. That's what I learned in Women's Gospel last night.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, I better go finish that Afghan for my mother.
Oh, Amy, I kind of did some stuff with that hooker. Nothing exotic, but just like missionary positions.
Okay. Oh, okay, George. As long as you teach our son, that's all I care about.
Okay.
Bye.
Slut. Hey, Matthew!
Oh, hey, George.
Doing some homework?
Yeah.
That's good. You know, I saw Mrs. Bildegard again today. She says you're doing much better in class.
Yeah. Yeah, I hardly ever go to her class. She's just so stupid, you know?
Damn, she seems pretty stupid. Listen, Matthew, the whole hooker thing,
I know it.
Well, you do?
Yeah, I know all about sex.
Well, how the hell do you know that? I mean...
Yeah, you don't have to go out of your way telling me. I know all about it.
Oh, that is great! You know, that is so great! I have been so frustrated. It reminded me of that time that I was frustrated when I shoveled the walks.
Yeah, so don't go out of your way telling me. I already know.
Oh, that is great. I am so relieved. Oh, thank you, Matthew.
For what?
For knowing about sex.
Yeah. Well, I better get back to this.
Oh, by the way, how did you know?
Oh. Well, I kind of got with twins on New Year's Eve.
Really? Were they conjoined?
No.
Oh, well, I did the exact same thing once. Oh, New Year's Eve 2005.
What? You cheated on Mom?
We just had sex. Get back to your homework.
So my advice didn't work?
Not really, but hey, it was a good idea. I wouldn't have thought of that.
Teaching a child about the laws of attraction and physical beauty can be a very confusing and frustrating experience.
You're telling me.
Cabbage?
No, thank you.
What you must realize is they will learn. They will learn. Whether you want them to learn or not want them to learn, they will learn. No matter who they are or what they're doing, they will learn. From television to radio, they will learn. From newspapers to watching hogs, they will learn.
Why would they watch hogs?
You mean you hadn't ever done that? Huh. It's terrific. Oh, sorry, but they will learn.
Thanks, Bo. I better be getting home.
Why? You tired?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's 4 a.m. and you've been saying they will learn for the last 7.5 hours.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Yep.
Hey, wanna get a room? Do me in it?
He's a freshman in high school.
Alright! I'll get out there and I'll talk shit! I won't talk to him, alright? I won't even swallow! Bitch!
Alright, I will.
He's a freshman in high school.
Alright, I'm done, alright? I'm gone! I'll talk to her!
He's a freshman in high school.
Wait! Having a freebie.
What are you doing later? Teaching a child about the laws of attraction and physical beauty can be a very frustrating and confusing time.
You know, add conjoined twin sex, followed by a BJ, followed by a rim job. I shit down one of the girls' throats, blew my load through the back of one of their heads. Later on, I fucked one on top of the ice box. Fucked one while she played minute waltz on the piano.